Let's study how to find time period of SHM in a given physical situation. We know well that SHM is executed about the point of a stable equilibrium. When we talk about mean position of SHM, this mean position of SHM is the point of stable equilibrium about which when the particle is slightly displaced from mean position, it will start executing simple harmonic motion. Now, when we talk about the calculation analytics about the time period of simple harmonic motion, there are three steps to be followed. There are three steps for calculation of time period. Let's write down the three steps. Step one is basically analyzing a stable equilibrium position, because we know well that at the point of equilibrium, all forces acting on the body are balanced. So, step one is just the same. It is balancing all forces on particle to find equilibrium position. We first develop a relation to find equilibrium position by balancing all forces on particle. That equilibrium position will be the mean position of particle. Next is step two, where we find a restoring force on particle if it is displaced slightly, say by a displacement y, from mean position. We find out the restoring force on particle if it is displaced slightly from mean position, and we try to express this force as a proportional function of y, such as we can find this restoring force is directly proportional to minus y, where minus sign is just indicating that it is a restoring force. And you can also transform it into an equality, and that can be written as say it is minus cy, where c is the proportionality constant. This is a relation which is developed after displacing the particle and finding the restoring force on it. We'll have some examples to understand it in detail also. The last step three is we find acceleration of particle at this position. This position means at a displacement y from mean position. So, acceleration can directly be written as restoring force upon mass, certainly minus c by m into y. Now, in this situation, as we are getting acceleration as minus c by m into y, we can compare it with the standard acceleration function of a simple harmonic motion, which is given as a is equals to minus omega square y. We already calculated this is the standard acceleration function in terms of displacement for a given SHM. So, here if we compare A is equals to minus C by MY with the A as minus omega square y, we can simply write comparing acceleration with standard equation for SHM, we get the angular frequency of oscillation is equal to root of C by M. Now, if angular frequency is root C by M, we know that in case of a circular motion or in SHM, time period of SHM we can write as t is equals to 2 pi by omega. On substituting the value of omega, we get time period as root of 2 pi root of m by c. This will be the time period of the given physical situation under which a particle is executing SHM. We'll have several examples to understand the same logic. Step by step in coming sections, we'll be moving ahead.